Hi everyone, today I have an unusual tutorial for you. That's because it's a number of tips and warnings I want to give you. As you know, I've been working on my game A Home in Darkness for quite a while, so I've got some experience in making 3D assets for that game. I don't consider myself on the same level as a professional 3D artist, but that's exactly why I want to make this video. There's a lot of stuff you need to consider when making 3D assets and levels in Blender, and it's something people don't find worth mentioning for some reason, although they are important. So let's talk about those. First up, use the metric system of Blender along with the snap tool. That way, you'll never have to worry about the size of your objects. Also, really helpful here are the front and side views of Blender. You can toggle between them by using the different numpad keys on your keyboard. Bonus: be sure to scale your objects in Blender in edit mode instead of object mode. That way, the default scale of an object is 1:1:1. Making working with it in Godot often easier. Next one, separate your objects. Don't create your level from a single object, use different ones. And also don't merge them all into one before export, you don't need to do that. This might sound obvious when talking about it, but let me give you an example of why that's important. Later on in Godot, you'll likely want to add collision shapes to your level objects. Unless you have a very simple level design, doing this manually won't give you the results you need. Luckily, Godot has the option to create a collision shape based on a 3D mesh. There are three options available with different use cases. I ended up mixing the different options for my level, as they are all useful to get certain results. Here's the example. The outer wall of my house uses the accurate option, create tri-mesh collision sibling. Because the fast one doesn't really give me the results I want due to the way I created these walls. Notice I can use a single object for the whole outer wall of one floor. On the other hand, there's the staircase. Here I'm using the simple and fast method, create single convex collision sibling, for creating a collision shape. Because by doing that, I get a slope as a collision shape. With the more accurate version, I'd get a collision shape that matches the staircase exactly, which is bad for my game, as it will make the player movement look weird. But again, take a close look. The railing and the staircase are here separate objects, because my automated slope wouldn't be created if railings were a part of the 3D object. That's why I tell you, really think about how you want to structure your objects in Blender, as this will make creating the collision shapes in Godot a lot easier. Told you the tip is important. Next one. Really think about how you want to export your 3D level from Blender into Godot. I recommend not using GLTF, use OBJ instead. The reason is simple, GLTF will get imported to Godot as a scene with a spatial node at its root, while an OBJ file will be imported as a mesh instance. And you can only create collision shapes in the automated way on mesh instances. So while all objects of your level can be in a single blend file, you should export them as separate OBJ files. Then in Godot, you just need to add them all to the scene on position 000. By doing that, the objects will align properly in Godot as they were in your blend file. But there's more to your export settings than just the file ending. How do you export your different objects in a single Blender file as separate OBJs? There is an option for that called Limit to Selection Only. Now only the objects you selected before the export will be exported into your OBJ file. You also don't need to export the material for each OBJ file as an MTL. Just make sure you have each material you need once and then assign the material in Godot. That way you make sure to not use needless copies of the same material, which helps with game performance. Also, no need to apply modifiers before exporting, because there is an option on export to just do that. So you can keep your modifiers on in the blend file, just in case you still want to tweak them later. Talking about modifiers, I personally really like the array modifier when making a tiled floor, but be careful when using it. You might end up with a lot of unnecessary faces inside your geometry. And these faces can mess up how the level looks in Godot due to Z-fighting, or can confuse the automated collision shape algorithms. I had to learn that the hard way, so you don't have to. On to the last part, UV maps. This can be rather tricky if you aren't using the matrix and snap features of Blender. You need to make sure that the pixel density of different objects is the same. Speaking of pixel density, it's often useful to have the image for the UV map double the size of what you need. That way, fine details take up more pixels in the image, making it less likely to lose important details when the image is projected onto an object in the distance due to mid-mapping. This is especially true for pixel art in 3D. Instead of using a 32x32 image with single pixel detail, you should consider using a 64x64 resized image just to not lose information when scaling the texture down via mid-mapping. Don't worry too much about texture size. Computers can handle very large sizes these days. So rather use one large texture than multiple small ones. Also very important, the mapping of the UV coordinates onto the UV map image is not exact. It's very much possible that you see artifacts because of that on the level geometry. To avoid those, make sure to have a reasonably large border area around your UV map unwrap that fits the color inside the unwrap. For UV map unwraps of tiles, I do the following. Each tile gets a 3x3 area assigned in my UV texture, while all unwraps are positioned in the center of the 3x3 area. By doing that, artifacts cannot occur and the tiles are properly tiled on the floor. So that's it. These are all the tips I can give you at this point in time. I hope this was useful to you. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, bye bye!